I'm Jake, and before I was blasted into some sort of weird wizard purgatory by he who shall not be named for legal reasons, I had two loves in my life, science and movies. So I decided to put myself in one of my favorite cinematic franchises ever, Harry Potter, to actually, you know, walk with me. To get you up to speed, this Dark Lord is killing anyone who defies him, has figured out a way to steal wizard's magic in the process, making him even more powerful. So I don't have my magic anymore, but I do have science, because there is a link between magic and science. Energy. So can we harness that energy to defeat the Dark Lord? And more importantly, can I survive the inevitable good versus evil showdown using energy to create an invisibility cloak via radiant energy, overcoming the force of gravity and flying with magnetic energy, and creating a magic wand through electrical energy? Could you survive Harry Potter? Headmaster Casey? What? What's happening?
Well, Jake, you died.
And I brought you back to life, and I wanted to bring you to the safest place I could think of, so here we are at my castle. Technically, it's a timeshare, but you know, now that you're back alive, I need to keep you safe from the Dark Lord.
Wait, hold on. Am I the boy who lived?
I don't know if I can legally say that, but your friends are here. Let's get inside and, Jake, I'll protect you.
Oh no. Sorry, Casey!
Jake! About time you got here. We're playing Magic Pool.
Oh yeah, cool. Sorry I'm late. You know, I died. Speaking of which, Casey's dead. I no longer have magical abilities anymore, and the Dark Lord and his evil henchmen are outside. They're probably gonna break through that door at any moment and kill us, I think.
Is that all? Jabril's and I got this.
Force field it!
Well, that's pretty convenient.
Oh, what's the point of being a wizard if you can't make magic work for you?
Anybody want tea?
Ooh, that sounds lovely.
What?
I want Earl Grey.
I have this spell that's perfect for tea.
Ooh.
Okay, sure, you know, I wish that I could still conjure forces. Side note, when we talk about forces, what we're talking about is the transfer of energy from one object to another. In physics, energy is the ability to do work. And work is what it takes to move an object with a force. And force is the transfer of energy that makes it happen. And there are four fundamental forces or energies that make everything in the universe, well, work.
There are the strong and weak nuclear forces, which are at the subatomic level. Then there are the forces of gravity. Gravity is what holds you to Earth.
But literally every other force you feel is electromagnetic. As far as you and your world is concerned, electromagnetic energy is what makes everything happen.
These energy waves travel with the speed of light and can be composed of radio waves, TV waves, heat, light, invisible waves.
It's what allows you to cook food in the microwave or watch your television or use your cell phone to communicate with other phones. Really going at it. We should probably head back inside. Electromagnetic energy is also what keeps your feet from falling through the ground, and it can seem pretty magical. Speaking of magical, you know, I wish I still had my powers and I could help defeat the Dark Lord and avenge my friend Casey, but I don't have a wand, and even if I did, don't think I could use one.
Oh, you need a wand? Just open that door.
Matt Pat, oh, it is good to see you, buddy, and also you look good as a painting. Yeah, wand. Don't think I could actually use one right now, so.
Oh, I know a guy, don't worry. All the answers to your needs are right behind that door.
Is that a rumor requirement?
Sure it is.
Oh, William Osmond, why are you in a closet?
If you're seeking a wand, you've come to the right place, my friend.
I'm just gonna stay out here, I think. That's a, oh no, okay.
I'm parched. I can go for some tea.
Welcome to my Muggle Wand Emporium, Jake. What do you think? It's brand new.
You know, I don't want to be critical, William, but it kind of looks exactly like my cystm lab.
Nope. It's my Muggle Wand Emporium. Let's check out my wares. Fire wand, high voltage wand, laser wand.
Pretty sure that's a flashlight.
No, it's a laser wand.
Is it? This flame wand creates fire by igniting a steady stream of propane, which causes it to release electromagnetic waves. Those EM waves both heat up the surrounding air and create the orange light that you're seeing. Fire is awesome, but unfortunately the flame wand's reach is only about 0.3 meters. So unless I get in close to my enemy, this wand will just make him a little warm. What else you got? The wand discharges a powerful electric field into, well, whatever we want. It generates a voltage of 200 kilovolts into these small and very painful bolts of lightning.
You see my little hand switch?
In this thermal shot, you can see that voltage trying to find the ground before finally striking. Sadly, the electrostatics wand reach is even shorter than the flame wand, mere centimeters. So yeah, that leaves the laser flashlight. Fine, laser wand. So this one packs a punch and from a distance, but why? Lasers use a coherent beam of light to focus power in a small space. And in this case, the laser wand is focusing a lot of power. But how does it cause such destruction? Well, when light hits something, it's either reflected or absorbed. And in this case, it's being absorbed by the atoms of our target, jiggling them about and converting that light into thermal energy, which causes them to burn. This seems like the best out of the three.
Jake, what do you think of the wands?
William, you did a great job. I don't think they're gonna do a really good job, though, against the evil wizard, because he's a wizard.
Okay, so. Well, individually they might be weak, but if we tape them together and form a super wand, I think that you'll have the
perfect-
You know,
okay, how about this? I'll just take them. No, you did last year tape. You keep that tape. I'll take these, I'll go fight the wizard, and I'll see you later. Well, that was interesting. And the, whoa.
God, it is so hard to see with this mask on.
Jake, hold still for me.
Oh no! Okay, well, that Death Eater must have gotten in here before Allison and Jabril's put on their protective force field.
Use the laser wand, dude.
Get up!
Is that a flashlight?
Not cool! Not the moneymaker!
All right, Allison, I got you here. Have you read this book?
Oh, I've read every book.
Huh.
Guys, okay, Death Eater must have gotten in before the force field. Okay, they're here, and we're trapped in a tower. I have no magic. What are we gonna do?
Brooms.
Yeah, brooms, that's a great idea, but you know that I can't actually fly.
To the roof!
Remember the whole no longer have magic, and they're gone. Yeah, that's cool, don't worry about me. I feel like a house elf. Worst friends ever! If only there was some way that I could hover or fly out of here.
What about harnessing electromagnetic energy in such a way that you could levitate?
Yeah, what now about that?
I mean, it's a theory.
Game theory!
No, a scientific theory. Just run off to your cystm lab and figure it out.
Yes, sir. Okay, that's a good idea.
Oh, come on! This is not gonna look good on my quarterly report.
So a flying broom would be the answer to all my problems. But unfortunately, that's not really an option for me. Or is it? This is a superconductor. And watch what happens when we put it on a magnetic track. Nothing. That's because we have to cool it to a balmy negative 178 degrees Celsius. And how do we do that? With liquid nitrogen. When the superconductor has been cooled below negative 178 degrees Celsius, it exhibits a really interesting property called the Meissner effect, which is when a superconductor completely expels magnetic fields. That is to say that a superconducting element will levitate over a magnetic track, even though the material itself isn't magnetic. The issue with a superconductor is you have to keep it at an extraordinarily low temperature, because once it warms up, the effect is lost. But if we can maintain that temperature, it does have a huge benefit over regular magnetic levitation, which is that it can levitate in any direction. Just like the brooms in Harry Potter. And it looks like magic. Unfortunately, Casey's timeshare doesn't have a magnetic track running through it. And riding a super cold broom isn't a viable option. So, Allison and Jabril's should be on the roof over there, so we should be pretty close. That is not good. Okay, yeah. Not having magic is the worst. I mean, I can't defend myself, I obviously can't fly, but I can hide.
I wouldn't open that. William's in there.
Oh, wait. William's in this closet, too?
Can you bring the wands back?
He's in all the closets. Why don't you just use radiant energy to hide yourself? Light is a form of radiant energy, and it's what makes us visible when people are searching for us.
Wait. So if we could manipulate radiant light energy, could I make myself invisible? I'm invisible! I'm just kidding. We'll get back to that thing in a minute. Now, invisibility, it might seem like a technology that will forever be in the realm of science fiction and fantasy, but in theory, it's a somewhat straightforward concept. One of the greatest discoveries of all time is that light is an electric and magnetic field carrying electromagnetic energy through space. Now, I don't want the electromagnetic energy of my body reflecting right now to reach the camera. Instead, I want the energy reflecting off of the background, that is what's behind me, to be what reaches the camera, therefore rendering me invisible to you. But how can we do that? How can I make myself, scientifically speaking, invisible? Well, one way is a lens system developed by scientists at the University of Rochester that renders things invisible by focusing the background image to appear in front of objects placed in front of it. But it's on a small scale and has areas where the object is no longer hidden, like this. Then there's the military. They're working on cloaking tanks using the same technology as that device I was holding in the beginning. This invisibility shield utilizes refraction to hide me. It's coated with hundreds of tiny lenticular lenses that redirect the rays of light around whatever we want to make invisible. Unfortunately, there are limitations to this. It's not fully invisible, and it doesn't deal well with complex backgrounds. Basically, it works best if I'm in front of something that is the same color as what I'm wearing, like this. Also, it's cumbersome and it doesn't work well with objects placed horizontally. This is due to the unusual shape of the lenticular lens. The bumps only bend light that run parallel to the orientation of the lens. I don't think either of these things is gonna hide me nearly as well as Harry's invisibility cloak. But since I don't have that, I'll just stick to hiding. Matt Pat, that was a great idea. Matt Pat? Where'd you go?
Jake Roper, face me now, you coward, or watch your friends perish.
What'd you say? I couldn't hear you. You know what? I'll be right down. Oh, sorry, Cat. Casey's timeshare's got a lot of stairs. Well, what'd you say? What's up?
I'm sorry, this hood
really baffles sound.
Derek? Dude, what are you doing, man? I thought we worked this out last season.
We did, but hunting you down is just too much fun.
Yeah, you should probably see a professional about that.
You know, it's cute. You think your off-the-shelf science gear can defeat me? Derek Muller, a physicist with a PhD? You're no match for me.
Well, this is what I got.
Looks to me like Veritasium was easily defeated. Easily? Get it? I'm a painting. Literally a painting. It's a painting pun!
Well, I'm out. I give, man. I'm done chasing you, Jake. And if you need me, I'll be over on my channel. Oh, and Jake, that laser wand really hurt.
It's not a wand! Why does everyone keep saying it's a wand?
Well, that went way different than I expected. You won.
I did, and I might not have gotten my magic back, but at least I didn't die. Actually, I don't think anyone died.
Except Casey, Jake.
Oh, yeah. He's real dead.
I missed you.
Really? And, as always,
thanks for watching.
Really? You know, I don't have magic, but I do have sadness. And that is my power.
This season on cystm.
Ah! Oh no. Come get some.
Let's make me hypothermic. Tear this body apart.
Oh, the need for speed.
I don't think you're gonna survive this one.